Hi there, welcome to this Nightcafe studio video from Mac Hatter. I am now going to show you a wee bit more in depth about start images. We'll go coherent first. We will use an image of my own. I do this a lot actually. I take a lot of photos and then I use them to try and adapt them a little bit. So let me just see if I can find something. Okay, so I took this picture. I was out just walking in my local little woods, and I seen this, and I thought, I wonder if I could manipulate that some way in Nightcafe and make it look, I don't know, maybe get some elves or something on it, or a wee elf house or something. So let's try that. One thing to notice is the shape of the input picture dictates the output. See, I can't change anything here. It says square, but it's not actually. It's going to be more like that shape. So the first thing we need to do, right, so let's go for an elves village. So let's try that on here. So a small elven village, pretty cottages dug in amongst the tree and the moss. Now what I normally do, this is just the way I work, I start with something really basic and then work on it and see what happens. Now we come down to these advanced options. So here you can put in a seed. So the more advanced you get and the more you do this, you'll find seeds that you like because they do a certain effect or whatever. So you end up with a list of seeds. So if you happen to have a seed that you know works well with this type of stuff, you could use it here. Overall prompt weight, how much should the final image match the prompt? Now I want it to match that a lot, so I'm just going to bump that up to 100. I want the image to match the prompt a lot. So I want it up to 100. Start weight image, how much should the final image match the start image? I want it to match it a lot, but not too much that it might not draw the houses and stuff. So let's start at 70. And noise, basically what noise is, the more noise there is, the further away it will be from the start image. But I like a wee bit. And I do 100 all the time, but I'm not going to do that this time. Let's take it down to 10 and leave it at that. Now the accuracy boost, none means that it goes through two models. I'm not getting into the technical stuff. If you want to know the technical stuff, join the Discord and ask in there. There's people in there who will give you a far better explanation than me, and quite frankly, you don't need to know it. You just experiment and you'll know. But just think of it, these get more accurate, basically. That's two models. Standard removes one of the models, which makes it more accurate because it takes more time, I believe. And extra just does more of the same. Just ask the guys in the Discord if you want a more technical explanation. And just for the crack, I'm just going to put in a seed. And no, I'm not. I'm just going to randomize it. Right. And it is a coherent. Now, I like to up coherent to medium, low res. But you've got to be aware it's 12 credits. Like, if you use none, it brings it down to 4. So let's just use none in this instance, because I know everybody doesn't have credits to burn, and we'll just see what happens. So let's go. I'll just pause it and we'll come back when it's done. In fact, I'll just do the artistic one now. So the easiest way to get everything the same is just come into this one and hit duplicate. So we've got the same prompt, the same picture, but up here we're going to change it to artistic. And that wee bit there. Always make sure you've got that on or you won't see all those additional settings. So make sure advanced options is on. And you don't get as many options with artistic. So just come down here. I'm just keeping it basic for the moment. Just so you can see what it does at basic levels. And we'll come back when they're finished. Okay, so let's have a look. So this is the coherent option. That is pretty impressive, you have to say. This is what I love about this. And this is a great thing to kind of throw back at people who say, AI art isn't art, you didn't do anything, you didn't make it. I took the photo, I came up with a prompt and I set the AI up to create that. The AI simply did what I told it. That is 100% my creation. So I love this. I think it's such a cool thing to do. So that's the coherent one. Not bad. Check the artistic one out. Even the artistic one's brilliant. Look at the houses in the back there. Look. You know, it's taken that image and just ran with it. Superb is all I can say. Superb. So let's just go back to the coherent one now and see if we can jazz it up even more. Now, what can we do? We'll evolve it. So evolving means you could add extra stuff, which is pretty cool. So I'm going to bump up the noise a wee bit up to 20. I'm going to put standard on this time. I'll leave that like that. And I'm going to elaborate on the prompt. And I'm just going to, just for the crack, I'm just going to use the fantasy preset and I'm going to bring it down a wee bit. Let's bring it down to about 4. So this prompt will be applied at that weight. Don't worry about that. I'll tell you all about the weights in another video. So let's see what happens. And I'm going to randomize the prompt just to see what happens. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to go into the artistic and I'm going to evolve this, but I'm going to evolve it over to coherent. So I'm using that as a start image now in coherent, and I will pop in the fantasy one as well, and I'll bring it down a wee bit. And we'll come in here. Overall prompt weight, yes please. Start image weight, yeah, let's go about 70%, and we'll put 30% noise in, see if we can make it a wee bit unique. And we'll bump it to standard. I'm going to bump it up to there as well, and I'm going to put low res, and we're away. Right, we'll be back when they're finished, see what happens. Okay, so the final two have gone. Look at that. That's pretty cool if you ask me. That's coherent. A small elven village, pretty cottages, dug in amongst the trees and the moss. Don't know what to say, can't get any better than that really. That's pretty cool if you ask me. And the artistic one that moved over to coherent, wow. Just wow, you know, it's amazing. There's even wee bits under here, there's stuff over there. It's pretty cool. And just as I've been making this video, Stable Diffusion has now gone live on in Nightcafe, so you'll see it like this now. In fact, if I go to my proper Nightcafe account, there we go. And just for the crack, seeing as it's just gone live, let me just do a Stable Diffusion one. Let's see what happens. So, Stable Diffusion, pop that in there. We want, what do we want? We want a landscape version. We want 16 images. I'll leave the prompt where it is, and I'll just leave that as it is. 7 credits, 16 images coming up. Stable Diffusion on Nightcafe. First time it's been shown anywhere is in this video. How awesome is that? And it's pretty cool. If I go over to my other, so this is the staging one, these are all Stable Diffusion, just me messing around, loads of Mac Hatters there. So get on there, get your pro account. Remember, if you use the Mac Hatter code, you'll get 5% off the cost of the pro subscription, whatever one you take, and believe me, it's worth it. This is a beast. It is unbelievable. So without any adaptation at all, there you go, look, isn't that, it's just mental, it's absolutely crazy. 16 images in under 30 seconds at that quality. Guys, go do it. I'm a moderator in Discord, so I need to go now and help everybody, but yeah, glad I could help. Shout any questions. Don't forget the 5% off Mac Hatter code. It will be in the description of the video, and the link will be there as well. If you click on the link, you'll get it. So good luck to you, and I'll see you soon.